Ciao a tutti, I am Roberto Zanardi. I work in ABB in the System Test Lab, and I'm gonna show you how it works the automatic transfer switch, main generator, open transition for XT breakers, as the one that you can see in the totem to my right. So I will show you the way we install this functionality on the breakers by using the software KeepConnect, and what is needed in order to install this kind of solution in our breakers in terms of accessories and functionalities on the 3P unit. So first thing to do is to connect the ABB TMP device in order to install the communication between your laptop and the 3P unit. So once the TMP is connected on both the sides, we can move on the laptop and start the software KeepConnect. Once the software is started, the first step to follow is to perform the login by clicking on the login button. We are logging in our ABB, MyABB site. In this way, KeepConnect recognizes your role inside the software and also all the functionalities that you can enable on your devices. With functionalities, I mean the functionalities that you can find on the marketplace. Here, on the catalog, of course, you can find the ATS main generator open transition, which is the one that we are going to install on our 3P unit. Second step to follow is to perform the TMP scan. We connected before the TMP to the laptop and to the 3P unit. Now it's time to scan the device by clicking on Scan TMP button. The KeepConnect is now installing the communication with the 3P unit. Let's check the connection of the TMP cable. Okay, the communication is running with the 3P unit. Now we need to install the automatic transfer switch main generator. To do that, we need to click on the Tools button, where we can find all the tools that we can install on our 3P unit. In this case, we are going to click on the embedded ATS functionality. We have two possibilities, the main timing close transition or the one related to this video, which is the main generator open transition. About the functionalities needed on the device and the accessories needed, we didn't say anything now because KeepConnect with this tool, the embedded ATS tool, can recognize by itself the accessories needed if they are connected and also if the functionalities, such as the measuring functionality, is installed on the 3P unit. So what we find here is a generic page about the main generator open transition. Customer need to click on this main generator open transition button and then can start to put some settings on the 3P unit. The most important settings to set are the threshold in terms of frequency and voltage. This threshold will start our automatic transfer switch in the reality. So we set this kind of threshold on the 3P unit. It depends on customer needs. Then we need to set all the times related to the automatic transfer switch. Those times are related to the generator to start, the opening time when we recognize a fault on one of the two sources, and so on. All the details about these settings are showed when you click on the information button. For example, the TS delay is the generator start delay after detection of a fault in the mains. Means it is the timing you want the generator to be started when a fault occurs on the mains. In this case, I want 2 seconds. Then, for all the others, you can find all the details, opening delay of the emergency CB line, And then just by clicking on the label here, you can set your needed timing for your solution. So by putting the timings, now I need to select a role for the breaker which I'm connected to. In this case, for example, this is my main breaker. When I click on main breaker, I need to perform a role association. Keep connect here shows the only one breaker which I'm connected to. And you may ask, you are connected via TMP, so of course it's only one. Yes, but you can also connect via TCP. So if you have an internet connection on your laptop where you can connect to all the breakers involved, then in that case you will have the list of the breaker found. Since I'm connected via TMP, it's only one. I select this breaker for this role. In this way, EquipConnect will assign this breaker, so we can see here the serial number of the trip unit of this breaker. This serial number will be related to the main breaker one on the ATS main generator. It means that when I will transfer the solution, this breaker with this name, so this serial number, is only related to the main breaker. I cannot change it to the generator or anything else. Now that I assigned it, I will check the role condition, which is the step that I said before. When I keep connect, check that all the functionalities and accessories needed are present on your device. In this case, we need the measuring package active on the XT2 breaker. Then we need, of course, the Equip Supply module, which allows us to connect to the Equip Link and the Equip Signaling module to K1. In this case, they are all present. If I disconnect one of the two modules, I will see a red cross here, and the module will be not present. In my case, they are all present. We have also some manual condition where we need to flag if the motor operator is present, because I keep connected to the trip unit, they cannot recognize automatically the presence of the motor operator. Once I selected this motor operator which is present, I can then transfer my solution on this breaker. I click on transfer button, then I keep connected is saying that we are enabling a solution, and so we are going to program some settings related to the solution on the device. I click yes. In this case, the automatic transfer switch was already present on this device, so EquipConnect is saying, okay, this device is already present with an automatic transfer switch. If you want to proceed with the action, you can do that and override the new settings on the old ones. So now EquipConnect is transferring all the settings to my trip unit. Of course, we are talking about up to 25 settings or more that are written inside the trip unit, and the programmer, as me in this case, cannot see them, all these kind of settings. We can see only the voltage, the frequency and the timings, but not all the programmable status and the logic inside the trip unit. This is the best way to let the customer set only what it needs in terms of functionality and behavior, not all the deep and detailed settings that he actually doesn't need to understand or know about. It's just a matter of the EquipConnect and embedded solution to transfer these kind of settings. Main breaker transfer success, generator breaker transfer failed. Of course it's like this because we only transfer the main breaker. Now I can click on OK, and by moving again on the video, we can connect to the other breaker. So now I'm just removing the TMP to the main breaker one and connecting it to my generator breaker. Connected the TMP there, I move again on the EquipConnect software, again on the scan page, I press again on the scan button. It happens sometimes that EquipConnect not recognize the TMP, just disconnect it from the laptop and reconnect it again. and then press the scan button. If you have some problem like this, just a few seconds later it starts working. It's a matter of driver's speed. So the communication is started also with the generator breaker. What we need to do now is just to move again to the tools page. Since I'm already logged in, I can move to the tools page. I'm already in the embedded ATS page. Now I can check again my main generator open transition settings, and they are stored as I did before. Now what we need to do is to click on the generator breaker, click on the role association button, select this new trip unit which I'm connected to, and do again the role conditions. Also in this case we have all the stuff needed, it's present. We just need to flag the motor operator and then click on transfer. Again we have the pop-up, the warning pop-up. I can click on yes, and again since a license was already associated, I need to click OK just to override the settings of my new automatic transfer switch. Ok, the transfer is completed, also on the generator breaker transfer success, main breaker transfer failed, of course because I'm not connected to the main breaker, I was connected to that before and it was transferring successfully, so that's alright. Now my solution is downloaded on my devices. So we have installed the automatic transfer switch on these two XT2 breakers. Let's see how it works with this simulation totem. First of all, this totem allows us to replicate the voltage and current signals directly to the trip units in order to simulate customer plans and so on. So that's why and how we can show how the ATS is working right now. The starting situation is with the main breaker closed. You can recognize it by the red LED here on the on position of this breaker, and the generator breaker in off position, so opened. By the interface here, I can recognize that on the main generator we do have the nominal voltage present with the nominal frequency present. The breaker is closed and our loads are supplied by the main breaker and by the mains. What happens when I have a fault on the mains? So I expect my main breaker to open, the generator to be started by the automation, and then the trip unit of the generator breaker will close automatically the generator breaker. So let's see how it works. I'm going to remove the voltage on the mains in order to start up the transfer switch. So I remove the voltage here. You can see the generator to be started. The main breaker is now open. And then, after the timing I put on the automatic transfer switch logic, the generator breaker is now closed. When the voltage on the mains is back, we will see the generator breaker to be opened, then automatically the main breaker one will be closed, will be closing. What happens now if I close manually when everything is set on automatic? I close manually the generator breaker. If I close it, I have the emergency ATS functionality working. It means that both the breakers are tripping by external trip. So we cannot manage manually the generator breaker when the main breaker is closed, so we cannot perform a manual operation, closing operation on the generator. So this is how the automatic transfer switch logic works when we installed it with our embedded solution and the KitConnect. So we are now moving back on the software, on the KitConnect, just to understand how to download this functionality from our marketplace, and then how to be able to install as we have seen before with the technology software. So I'm here on my Keep Connect 3 software. I'm going to the marketplace page. As you can see here, I can see a catalog of the functionality that I can download. There is the voltage protection functionality, advanced protection, voltage protection functionality, and so on. We have also the all-in-one licenses, such as the automatic transfer switch and generator. In this case, the licenses that I can buy are the load chanting adaptive and the ATS main time and close transition. We don't have the ATS main generator open transition because we already have installed it on my devices. In any case, when you need a new functionality, you just need to press the buy button. You will be linked to our ABB marketplace. You can start to buy the functionalities. As the functionality is bought by you, you will recognize the presence of the functionality on the Keep Connect 3. Then you can go on my device and load the tool you have already bought on the marketplace.